Loving it. Alright, alright. Come on, what are we doing? Alright. There you are. Hi. I'm gonna try my new brushing method.
Because nobody quite knows why, but in Japan, the term has morphed from curry to kare. Not only that, but the Japanese actually call it kare rice, which is curry and rice. I suppose Japanese people can't conceive of curry without the rice that comes with it. Either way,
oh, yeah, that works.
Types of food in this country.
Nice.
I'm standing in front of a curry restaurant, which is part
of the chain. Do you like
it? It's located in an extremely
busy
commercial area, which is full of both students and office workers. You buy a ticket from this machine with your choice of food. The menu is here down on the left.
Ah,
you could have your curry with,
can't forget brushed again.
Pork cutlet, chicken cutlet, wiener sausages, fried shrimps, or all of the above. So, pork cutlet is one of my favorites, but I'm actually going to go for chicken cutlet today, okay? And my ticket should have
been... Well, it's not as efficient as the Furminator, but...
Okay.
It does work.
We're going to meet the Chibas, a typical Japanese family who live in
Saitama. It works very well on Matilda. It has kind of shorter hair.
It's
very difficult to brush, actually, because her hair is so short. But
Japanese curry with rice is distinguished by the many ingredients that go into the stew. Onion, carrots, potato are absolute essentials. In this family, the carrots are sliced thin because the daughter isn't fond of them. The potatoes are usually put in as big, easily identifiable chunks. As they stew in the curry, they lend it sweetness.